Driving a bass boat. So you've never done it, or you've never really been taught the basics of driving a boat. My buddy over here, Miles Wickham, he just got a new bass boat. It's not new, it's new to him. Miles would like a lesson on all the bass boat basics. He's never driven a boat any extensive period of time, is that right?
That's right. Yeah.
And so he asked me the other day, he said, had a bunch of questions about driving a bass boat. I said, you know what? I bet you you're not alone. There are a lot of people out there that want to know the basics about driving a bass boat. I've been driving one ever since I was a young teenager, and I've been all over the world in all kind of different conditions, and I've had to learn. I've asked a lot of questions about people that are very experienced, but I'm going to just try to give you all the basics. So if you've never had a boat, once you get it on the water, we're not going to cover how to launch a boat right here. We're just going to cover on how to drive one. So once you get your boat in the water, we're in the water. Rule number one, put your PFD on, put your life jacket on. I really like the foam life jackets. This is a Mustang jacket, but then you want to make sure that it fits well, doesn't ride up too much, and it fits you snug. Rule number one, put that on. Get your kill switch attached. Before you go anywhere in your bass boat, you want to make sure that your kill switch is attached. And what a kill switch does is that when your motor's running and you go down the lake, let's say something happened, you hit a log or you hit a wave and you get thrown out of the boat. Well, if you get thrown out of the boat, that's going to cut the engine off. That's why they call it a kill switch. It kills your engine from continuing to run while you're going down the lake. So that's kill switch attached, life jacket on, rules number one and two. Rule number three is, this is your throttle. Most bass boats come with a TH Marine hot foot. Not all of them do. Some of them have a hand throttle. And so what happens is, this is neutral. You're gonna stay right here in neutral when you're starting the engine. So when you start the engine, it's gonna be in neutral. And when you start your engine, most every engine, you want to turn it over and wait just a second or two before you actually crank it. And then your engine is going to crank up. You're going to, no matter what, you want to let that engine, whether it's two-stroke or four-stroke, you want to give that engine at least 3 to 5 seconds to, get lubricated for all the oil to go throughout the engine. And before you mash on the throttle, at least 3 to 5 seconds. If you want to wait 10 seconds or more, that's fine too. But you want to make sure that you don't start that engine and then just mash it to the floor immediately. That's one tip. And then you're gonna squeeze this together. And this is a Mercury, but it doesn't matter if you have other engine brands. They all work similar. You can put the throttle in. That is going forward. Lift it back up, and that is gonna go reverse. Sounds basic, but that's the way it is. There are no brakes. There is no brake pedal in here. Your brake, if you need it, could be this reverse button right there. But you can't be going too fast in the forward motion in order to slam it into reverse. You'll tear up the gears in your lower unit, because the gears in the lower unit, no matter what engine you have, the gears going forward are big and beefy and strong, because that's where you're going to be going fast. Your reverse gears are not near as strong, and so you can't really hammer on it too much without causing damage to your lower unit. So you just keep that in mind when you're thinking about your reverse, and you want to kind of come to somewhat of a slow speed before you change from forward to reverse or from reverse to forward. But then as you get, you want to go forward. So we're pointing in the back of this pocket. We're going to turn around, go towards the outside of the pocket as we're going to try to go somewhere. So I'm going to put it into gear, going forward. I'm going to turn the wheel to get us to go towards the open water. And then before we go to go in a faster motion, what we're going to do is we're going to trim all the way down. You may have the trim on your throttle. You may have these turnstile signals right here, but I'm gonna just go ahead and I'm gonna run, you're gonna run your trim all the way down. Now what that does is when you go to get on plane, you know, your boat's sitting in the water at this point right here, you know, in a lower motion. When you go to get on plane, you wanna have that engine tucked as far under as possible so that when your boat comes up, that you can, that it will break, what they call break over. It will break over and you'll be able to get on plane. And then once that boat breaks over, you're gonna want, you'll feel it, that boat will stabilize, start going in a straight motion. Then you're gonna trim the motor up slowly, smaller increments, to be in somewhat of a neutral area. If you're going a normal speed, when you're gonna go higher speeds, you're gonna trim that motor up a little bit more. It will help lift more of your boat out of the water and you can go faster, but one step at a time. Let's get on plane first. So I'm gonna show you exactly, I double check to make sure the trim on the engine is all the way down. If you have a jack plate, you probably wanna have that in a lower position. I've got a jack plates 101 video if you wanna check that out as well. But right now we've got this down all the way, everything's trimmed, and you're not gonna ease into it. You wanna go ahead and ease the throttle all the way down. You don't wanna slam it down. You wanna ease it all the way down, full throttle. So you're gonna go full throttle. Once you get on plane, then you back off. You get it on plane, then you can back off. I'm still fully trimmed down. You wanna keep at least one hand close to the steering wheel. And then you're gonna be able to turn easily. Once you start picking up the pace, you wanna trim that motor up a little bit and lift, because that, with it being trimmed all the way down, the hull is being driven into the water. You're gonna be very stable, but slow. It was just a cruising speed. I've trimmed up just a couple ticks. And as you can see, it's not tucked way under, and there's no rooster tail. Okay, so you've made a run, you're coming off plane, you're gonna wanna ease off the throttle, but still keep the throttle down until you've totally settled in the water. And I'm gonna say that again. When you're coming off a plane, you wanna slowly let off the throttle until the boat comes off a plane and settles. You don't wanna just totally kill the throttle, because what'll happen is that the boat will totally sink in. Sometimes water will come over the back. You really kind of lose control of the boat. But if you just ease off of the throttle, let the boat settle down, and then you can ease the throttle back and you're in a more controlled motion. So that's the basic run and movement. But I'll tell you one other thing is that when you get into an area where you're trying to maneuver in tight quarters, I see this common mistake made all the time. This will help you be a lot better boater, cause you a lot less headaches. When you're driving an outboard engine, if you're trying to maneuver in a tight area at a slower speed, you wanna go ahead and trim your motor up a little bit, because if you keep your motor tucked all the way down up against the hull, when you put your motor in reverse, all your thrust is just gonna be going against the back of your boat. And you're not gonna really get any thrust to go anywhere, if that makes sense. You're just gonna be pushing the water really hard up against the back of your boat, and then it's gonna be dispersing. If you take and trim that motor up just a little bit like that right there, and then you go to make a reverse turn, when you turn your motor, it's gonna be thrusting more water under your boat to where you can actually get some traction and movement out of the back of your boat. I'll show you what I'm talking about right here. So I've trimmed the motor back up and I put it in reverse. Now we're actually moving somewhere. I mean, we're going somewhere, and if I'm going to turn, we're turning. We're turning in reverse quickly. As opposed to you're going forward and you're trimmed all the way down. As you can see, that motor is, it's what they call tucked. It's tucked all the way up under. the thrust is going to be pushing up against the boat. So I'm going to be in reverse now. See, we're barely moving. I mean, I've got a pretty good amount of throttle in there. We're barely moving in reverse because that all that thrust is going up against the back of the boat. And even if you go to turn, you can turn, but it's a slower turn than if you have that motor trimmed up. So when you're maneuvering in tight quarters, just remember, go ahead and trim that motor up, because your reverse is going to be much more effective. You're going to be actually to make some more movement. You're going to have easier turns. And when you're going forward in slow speed, like idle, it's not going to make a big difference. That helps. I learned that many, many years ago. I had a friend of mine point that out to me, and that has really helped me in as far as maneuvering, going slow with a bass boat. So there's your quick, short bass boat basics, bass boat 101, if you will, on driving a bass boat. I will tell you real quickly, as far as going through the, you know, maneuvering around waves is something that you want to be conscious of as well. That's almost a second course, but for the 101, I'll give you a quick, if you have 0 to say 2 foot chop, the more you keep that motor tucked down to where the hull is going to be more stuck to the water, the waves will be, you know, dispersed by the hull of the boat. If you have more than about a 2 to 2.5 foot wave action chop or a boat wake, you can't just spear through that wave with your hull and expect it to do its job and just disperse the wave. You're going to have to, you know, slow down and keep the front of your boat up. So you're going to have to slow down to a point to where the tip of your boat starts to come up. Then you can take those bigger waves. And that doesn't matter if it's, you know, huge windy waves, or if it's, you know, you're going down the lake, like, you know, a Smith Mountain Lake or any, you know, Lake Norman, where you got big boats making 3 and 4 foot waves. You come up on one of them waves, you've got to slow down to the point where the tip of your boat, the front of your boat, is starting to come up. It's almost like you're starting to come off a plane. Get the tip of that boat up, and you can chop through those big waves, and you can stay safe. You're not going to lose control, anything like that. But if they're smaller waves, like I said, you know, 2 foot or less, you can just run right through them with no real problems. And if you're maneuvering around waves that are running catty corner, you know, or, you know, not perpendicular or parallel to you, if you're running on those waves, you want to just make sure that you keep the front of your boat level. You know, so as the boat starts to lift, you want to turn it back. Just keep the front of that boat level. But we can definitely get into more of that as we do more advanced courses on bass boat driving. But this was Bass Boat 101. I hope you learned something. My boy Miles over here, did you learn a little bit?
I did.
That's good. That is good. So Miles will be a little bit more informed out there, but I'll have to give him more advanced courses here very shortly.